This is basically Rhino for Recursive Design Studio. What we do, biasanya dalam recursive design ialah kita akan menggunakan a lot of tools, basically computers lah, and the appropriate software and plugins. So one of the software yang kita gunakan ialah Rhino with the dia punya plugin Grasshopper, which I believe Rhino 6 comes with Grasshopper built in. And then we will be instructed by Nuramin. Nuramin is currently doing his fourth semester, which is the thesis. Dan Amin adalah orang yang paling berpengalaman dalam recursive design. So he did recursive ketika dia punya third year, and then he did once again ketika dia punya master's pre-thesis. Dia buat thesis on recursive last semester, and dia nak buat lagi sekali what's this semester. Okay, so empat semester of recursive, kalau you tak jadi expert, I tak tahu. So software, Amin gunakan macam-macam software, tapi I think Rhino dan Grasshopper ni adalah his best combination, is it? So dia boleh menyelesaikan masalah dia dengan cepat dan mudah. So we are going to watch his demonstration, basically how to use Rhino dan Grasshopper untuk produce a recursive facade. Okay, selepas you tengok this demonstration, you might be you might want to explore different options. This that one is totally up to you. Maknanya kalau you rasa I can do this using Revit and Dynamo, by all means do so. Kalau you pakar dalam SketchUp dan nak gunakan SketchUp and use some of the parametric plugins, you can do so as well. Or maybe kalau you nak buat totally manually macam saya cerita itu, you nak calculate everything by hand atau kertas berjejela, by all means do so. Tapi remember, semester ni ada 4 bulan je. So you have to do everything and complete your design within that 4 months. Okay? I mean, off to you.
Okay. Okay, everyone boleh dengar?
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Everyone boleh nampak? Okay, this is the parametric facade. It's based on diamond patterns. And being parametrically adjusted by few other parameters through dia punya extrusion, dia punya scale. Kalau if you can see, I'll show to the front view. Okay, kalau from this front view, you can see dia punya opening depan dia, they're different in sizes. Maksudnya dia scale from to a very small scale to a very large scale. And dia parametrically adjusted based on dia punya height. Means kalau tengok dekat bawah ni, dia very large, and dekat atas ni is very small in terms of opening. And then kalau tengok from the 3D, you can see yang dia punya protrusion, extrusion of the facade panel ni, dia parametrically adjusted juga so that belah yang bawah ni, dia a bit shorter compared to dekat atas. And then this is the this is another types of facade yang you guys akan nampak today. This is a facade yang akan going to be coded based on the rotation angle. Dia punya rotation angle tu, dia akan do the parametric design on the rotation angle so that each panel tu akan rotate in a different angle. And you have to understand yang everything yang parametrically designed today eventually akan being akan connected to the environmental part, because you guys are in environmental punya studio group juga at the same time, even though you are doing recursive, because these are the two main things that you have to justify in this semester kan. So whatever parametric design yang you come up now, yeah I will be showing to you, dia akan moving towards being environmental. Although at this time, masih as for today, kita tak akan touch on that environmental part lagi. Kita just akan show a little bit of justification lah. Maksudnya kenapa it works that way. Kenapa I choose to rotate it that way. Kenapa I choose to extrude it that way. Boleh faham ah? You guys okay?
Okay, faham.
Okay, faham? Okay.
Boleh.
Okay, now we can start.
Boleh.
Okay, first kali semua dah buka Rhino and Grasshopper? Semua dah buka Rhino?
Dah.
Okay, buka buka Rhino dulu. I'll close first everything.
Okay.
Okay, now buka Rhino. And then choose large object meters dekat new. And then you guys akan nampak this window. And then, once dah buka, I want you guys to type Grasshopper. Dia akan keluar this link, Grasshopper, and then click enter. So sekarang ni kita akan ada dua windows. Mostly, kalau buat Rhino and Grasshopper ni, kita akan work in these two windows. Satu Rhino, and then another one is Grasshopper. Basically, I will not be modeling in Rhino, means sebab Rhino is the modeling tools macam SketchUp, where you construct everything one by one. Means through the surface, through the lines and everything. Tapi when it comes to Grasshopper, it's a different canvas yang where all the parametric design, where all the coding tu boleh generate the same thing juga. Boleh generate a 3D model, but at the same time dia akan ada banyak variables. Dia boleh adjust your variables to your needs. Maksudnya dia boleh generate so many outcomes in a very short time compared dengan kalau kita nak buat satu-satu dalam SketchUp. Okay, now what I want you to do is pergi dekat Grasshopper, tekan file and then tekan new. Okay, dapat kan? Nanti dia akan keluarkan satu blank page. This is a blank page of Grasshopper. Okay, what I'm going to do now is to open existing file yang I already buat for you guys today. And this is the whole coding yang you guys akan siap at the end of the class. So kita akan start one by one. So kita akan start from this. Okay, this is yang dah siap eh. Okay, what I want you guys to do first is dekat Grasshopper, double click on the canvas and then type polygon. So dia akan keluar polygon. Dia akan keluar this one polygon. Boleh nampak? Sama tak?
Okay, sama.
Okay, kalau tengok dekat polygon ni, dekat P, dia ada P, R, S and RF. Kalau tengok kita boleh nampaklah P is for the plane, R is for the radius, S for segment and RF is for fillet radius. So just untuk cepat, kita nak just set up dia punya radius to 10. Double click dekat canvas and then just tulis 10. And then enter. And then tarik from number 10 ni, kalau nampak dia ada satu bulat kat sini. From the dial, tarik dia dial tu pergi dekat R. So maksudnya at this moment radius of this hexagon is 10 meter ataupun any units yang you guys tengah guna sekarang. In my case dia punya unit sekarang is meter. And then let's say lah kita nak surface, kita tak nak guna hexagon because it could be different sikit. Kita just nak guna a box. So kita akan guna, cuba double click again on the canvas and then tulis 4, which is 4 sides. And then connect dia to the S. So dia jadi 4 sides. So sekarang kita akan jadi rectangle. Okay? Dapat?
Okay.
Okay. Now kalau perasan, kalau tengok from the axis of the Rhino ni, dia tengah sengit tau. Maksudnya the rectangle ni a bit sengit. Maksudnya dia 45 degree sengit to the X and Y. So I just want you guys to rotate, double click on the canvas and then tulis rotate and dia keluar komponen ni. And I want you guys to sambungkan P, which is kat sini is the polygon, to the G. Okay, and then dekat A, kalau nampak A is for the angle, tapi dia kira in pi. So kita nak dia kira in pi. So I want you guys to double right click on A, and then dia akan keluar degrees. So tekan degrees. So nanti dia akan ada this shape. And then double click on the canvas, tekan 45 or 45 degrees, and then connect dia to yang dekat rotation tadi. So sekarang dia akan rotate for 45 degrees, so dia akan lebih dia akan in a 90 degrees angle. Okay, sekarang ni kita akan nampak dua macam ni kan. And this is not what we want. The thing is, dia akan view every steps of your coding tu. So what you have to do is click dekat the first component yang polygon tadi, right click, and then tekan dekat preview. Dia akan off the preview.
Oh.
So this is your line sekarang. Dia dah rotate.
Amin, basically, zoom out sikit you punya ni. Grasshopper tu. I nak tengok tu segment. So segment. The item miss kat depan tadi.
Okay, mana?
Yang buat tadi segment and radius. Okay, right. Thanks.
Okay. Tu je. Actually kalau nak actually for now just do this tu je lah. Tu ada, okay. Okay. So sekarang basically kalau dalam SketchUp, this is just about lukis a rectangle kan. Sebenarnya senang je kalau dalam SketchUp. It's just about tarik satu line and then jadi rectangle. Tapi in Grasshopper, this is the essence of it. They allow you to change benda tu, to change everything dengan lebih senang. Let's say lah, you guys nak tukar the radius of the square. You just have to, kat radius ni just slide je ke belakang. Ke belakang, ke depan, ke belakang, ke depan. Then dia akan change size. And then let's say dekat segment, you guys cuba dialkan dia up. Dia akan tukar pada lagi banyak sides. Dia akan tukar pada triangle, circle is a different thing. Tapi for this side is just dia punya minimum is triangle, and then to squares, and then to pentagon and hexagon. Tapi for this exercise kita akan just guna square first lah. Okay, kalau dalam SketchUp kita ada push kan, kita boleh pushkan everything tu untuk jadi solid. Tapi for Grasshopper, cara dia the concept is the same, cuma dia leceh sikit sebab dia nak letak the parametric part. So the next component that you guys akan guna is nama dia extrude. Double click on the canvas and type extrude. And then connectkan G from the geometry to the B, which is the base, the profile of the curve. Okay. Tapi once you connect, dia belum siap lagi. Sebab D, kalau tengok dekat loft, dekat extrude ni, dia ada D, which is the direction. Dia perlukan direction dekat mana kita nak extrude benda tu. Which in this case, kita punya extrusion is dekat Z, axis kan? So, I want you guys to double click dekat canvas and then type unit Z. So, dia akan keluar this component. And then I want you guys to connectkan V ni, which is the unit vector, to the direction. So dia akan start keluar macam ni. Dapat?
Okay, dapat.
Okay. And then, kita dah naikkan extrude dia through dekat Z, tapi dia tak ada unit berapa banyak Z yang dia kena naik. So this is where the part of the height of the building usually akan come in lah. So let's say I will just put 50 meter. Just double click on the canvas and just type 50. And then connectkan dia to the Z. And now dia akan jadi bukan solid block. Dia akan jadi a square shape yang dah di extrude. Okay, dapat?
Okay.
One thing yang after this is a bit one of the few things yang a bit leceh about Grasshopper, but still dia allow so many tweaks and everything. You have to understand, once bila dia dah jadi macam ni, you cannot select each face of the solid blocks tau, of the models. This thing dia akan work as a whole. Whereas kalau dalam SketchUp, in this case kita dah boleh select satu surface kan, betul lah? Kita boleh select surface yang mana-mana kita nak. Tapi in Grasshopper, dia punya cara dia a bit different. Imagine this model sekarang is a four surface of panel, pair of four surface of panels. Maksudnya dia ada empat surface ni, tapi dia all together. So apa yang you guys are going to use is to deconstruct all these four pieces into for a single face, untuk a single surface for each one. So double click on the canvas and then type deconstruct. And then go for this, deconstruct B-wrap. Dia akan keluar this one. And then connect kan from E ni, the extrusion results to the B-wrap. Okay, and then pergi balik dekat extrusion tu and then you can right click and tekan preview off. Okay. Okay. So sekarang, ah ya?
Ya, you're going too fast.
Too fast ke? Sorry.
Okay, wrap yang tadi tu.
Yang mana?
Kita buka pada diorang untuk tanya.
Okay, okay. Sure. Yeah.
Teruskan, sorry.
Ah, teruskan.
Teruskan, habiskan this part.
Kemudian okay. Okay, sekarang ni dia akan deconstruct. Deconstruct ni maksudnya dia akan ibarat macam explode lah. Dia akan explode this solid into a different types of elements. Kalau tengok F ni is for faces. Maksudnya is the surface of the block. Kalau you guys double click dekat canvas and then tekan surface, dia akan keluar this model, this tools, tekan surface and then connectkan F to surface and then offkan deconstruct, offkan preview deconstruct. Okay, now you get surface sahaja. Boleh faham setakat ni? Okay, kalau tengok dekat surface ni, cuba just hover your mouse dekat surface, dia akan keluar this value. Dah nampak tu, ada four values of inherited from one source. Ada four untrimmed surface. Maksudnya dia each surface of this facade, each surface of this blocks. So apa yang kita akan buat, kita akan select one of the four surface ni untuk kita letak kita punya facade. Okay, what you going to do is next one is tekan double click on the canvas lagi and then tekan list item and then ambil yang this one, list item. Okay, and then dari surface tu connect the surface to the list. Kita tadi ada empat list of surface, kita connectkan ke atas ni. Okay, these components allow you untuk choose satu of the surface from the, all the fours. So tapi dekat sini kita let's say lah kita nak choose yang okay, sorry eh. Macam ni, let's say okay, macam ni. Okay, next thing yang you have to do is double click on the canvas, tekan 0 smaller than 3 and then dia akan keluar di slider. Dapat? Why 0? Kenapa dia 0 until less than 3? Is maksudnya 0 is sekarang kita tahu dia ada 4 values of surface dalam ni. So kita nak ada dial yang from 1 to 4. Tapi in this case dia akan always start from 0. So in this case dia akan 0, 1, 2, 3. So connect yang this slider to I. And then you guys boleh off yang surface, tekan dekat surface, right click, off preview. And then now you guys akan tinggal satu je surface. Boleh dapat?
Okay.
And then cuba kalau slide kan yang 0 to 3 tadi, slider tu, dia akan dapat this result. Maksudnya dia akan choose which, dia akan choose salah satu of the surface.
Okay
dapat eh? Okay, in this case, okay, next is
okay, jap. Okay, pause dulu.
Okay.
Alright. So guys, any questions? Sekarang ni I just recap balik apa yang Amin buat for the past 15 minutes tadi. It's basically using parametric system yang mana you sekarang ni diberi satu graphical representation of what you can do on your 3D model. I mean, you guys have used SketchUp before, kan? Macam-macam you dah boleh buat menggunakan SketchUp. Tapi SketchUp is working like more of a an artist punya perspective. So you are doing a model of a cube, for example. So you know, first kali yang you akan buat, you akan draw a square dekat dalam plan, and then you extrude or push pull into for the height yang sama dengan the dimensions of the plan. So itu adalah cara kita sebagai designer to draw or construct. However, from programmer point of view, dia orang nak buat square tu, dia tahu it's going to have six surfaces. Dia tahu one dimension fits all. So they want to do it mathematically, right? However, apa yang you lihat kat sini is a graphical representation of that mathematical equation. So kalau Amin boleh fokus pada yang kita punya tadi tu, yang bawah tu, that surface tu, right? So we started off from with the polygon. So polygon ada macam-macam benda kita boleh buat. Kita boleh ada banyak surfaces, kita boleh ada dimensions on the height, sorry, dimensions on each of the surfaces, radius dan sebagainya. So setiap satu tu boleh diubah. So Amin sekarang ni telah menggerakkan satu slider yang on the segments tu. So segments ada empat, switch off yang, okay. So segments ada empat. So sekarang ni kita boleh just change it seamlessly. You nak berapa, 20 segmen atau just 3 segmen or whatever. And then you juga boleh control the pin radius, which is the general dimension of it. Yeah, so you just control. Okay. Benda ni penting because bila you dah buat model yang besar nanti, yang kompleks, you don't want to go back to one of the earliest brick yang you buat and change it. Kemudian realizing that you have to change all the other bricks juga. Okay, so kat sini, the control system yang diberi kat sini allows you to control individual elements dan change for everything. So contohnya, you dah terbuat satu brick dengan size sekian-sekian. Okay, and then the brick is wrong. Client, you kata the brick should be bigger. So all you need to do is just to adjust, then dia akan adjust accordingly. If you do this dekat dalam SketchUp menggunakan component, dia tidak akan adjust for the size, for the location. So dia punya model tu akan overlap with each other. However, with parametric modeling, you can have positioning, location, yang mana dia bukan sahaja akan adjust dia punya size, tapi dia juga akan move or rearrange everything automatically for you. Okay? So yang apa yang lihat kat sini adalah graphical representation. Don't worry, we don't have to repeat it again because this is recorded. Nanti you boleh review balik menggunakan the video, and then you boleh pause sesuka hati you dan layan muka Amin sesuka hati. Okay. Alright, so Amin, please continue. Yeah.
Okay. If you guys dah install yang plugin yang I give tadi, yang lunchbox tadi, now you have to double click on this on this canvas and then type hexagon. Type diamond. Dia akan keluar this tools, namanya diamond panels. Dapat?
Tak ada.
Ah, tak ada. Oh, mungkin kena load balik kot. Kena load. Cuba save dulu. Save the grasshopper file. Save dulu grasshopper file and rhino file. And then tutup and buka balik.
Tak apa, you continue, I mean.
Yeah.
Huh? Tak apa, you just continue. Nanti
okay. Lebih. Okay, sure. Okay, sekarang ni, this is, kita dah move towards applying a pattern on the surface now. So, in this case, it's not, there are banyak types of patterns that you can use. From the basic pattern, let's say lah, from triangle, from diamonds, to squares, rectangle, you nak ada random rectangles, you nak hexagon, you nak octagon and everything, semua boleh. And all these things akan be available from this plugin, which is yang tadi tu nama dia lunchbox. Kalau you guys pergi dekat grasshopper and then tekan lunchbox kat atas, ataupun kalau nampak kat sini L je dia akan tulis. dia akan keluar, dia akan keluar this table, this tools kat atas ni. Cuba tekan dekat panels, this one, and you guys akan nampak dia punya list of panels yang you can do. Okay. Ada diamond panel, hexagon, quad and everything. And basically the concept dia semua sama je. It's all, dia kena ada satu surface and then kita boleh apply any patterns to it. So in this case, kita akan choose untuk buat diamond first. So kalau dah boleh dapat, tekan diamond. And then, kalau tengok dekat from yang previous tools ni, previous element ni, nama dia list item ni, the result dekat I ni is a surface yang kita dah select tadi. Okay. Kalau tengok preview balik, okay, dia dah dapat one surface. And then kalau nampak dekat diamond tools ni, dia ada SRF. SRF tu of course for surface. And then connect I tu to the S. Jadi surface. And then previewkan dekat situ. Now, dia dah ada diamond patterns on the surface. Okay, dapat? And then, kita nak control the value of berapa banyak diamond panels ni on the outer surface. So dia akan being managed by this U and V. It's a division of surface by U and V. U division and V division. Basically dia macam X and Y lah. Cuma in this case dia tulis nama as U and V. The same thing you guys have to do is double click on the canvas and then let's say type 10. Means ada 10 units. And then for U pula, just type, double click again on this canvas and then type, let's say 20. Oh sorry, terbalik. Okay. And then go for the 20 tu, connect pada U. And 10, connect pada V. Okay, dapat? And then, kalau you guys play with the dial kat sini, dekat slider ni, cuba slidekan 20 tu pergi lagi banyak. So dia akan create lagi banyak pattern. So tapi in this case, just guna 20. Just aware that lagi banyak pattern tu nanti dia akan lagi berat lah. That's the thing about this thing lah. Okay. Untuk memudahkan korang untuk faham, what you guys can do from the previous code ni, you guys boleh groupkan tau. Okay, and then select, the way untuk groupkan dia is just buat a drag section from left to right, selecting all those panels and all those tools sebelum tadi. Dia akan highlight everything and then right click, tekan group. So dia akan groupkan everything. So that nanti kalau kita nak move, dia boleh move sekali. Kita tak payah tekan satu-satu. And then kalau nak lagi senang manage, kita boleh describe apa group ni guna, apa the function of the group. Right click on the group and then click kat atas ni, kita boleh letak surface. So nanti bila dah banyak-banyak, you guys akan understand, okay, this part is the surface. This part is the tools untuk edit the surface. Sebab this one kita dah pergi ke tempat lain. Okay, now kita dah sampai the diamond pattern. Okay, from the diamond pattern, sekejap, let me.
Yang diamond tadi tak keluar.
Ah, tak keluar?
Oh, dia tak ada kak. Dah matikan, buka balik pun sama.
Tak keluar. Tadi dah install lunchbox.
Lunchbox.
Ada install tapi dia tak
keluar. Tak keluar.
Oh, iya ke? Tak keluar ke?
Probably not the same plugin.
Wait.
Lunchbox, what's the other one?
Tak, dia still lunchbox. Cuma mungkin version lain pun. Jangan. Okay, how about I give you this one. Cuba try download yang this one lah.
Tak apa, because dia recorded, so it's nanti okay. Get that one out. Kalau tidak, dia membazir masa just trying to figure that one out on.
So ni nak teruskan ke tak ni?
Tapi you just send the file first and then okay. So that probably somebody else yang akan buat benda ni will also stumble with the same problem.
Okay. Okay, cuba try this one lah. This is a older version of Lunchbox.
So basically ketika installation ni kita close dulu lah kan, Rhino?
Yes. Tapi apa pun save dulu.
No, proceed dulu.
Okay. Okay, now the first, I would call it as variables. Variables yang kita akan buat, yang kita akan modify to this to the diamond panels is the extrusion of the panels. Means dia akan produce this result. Maksudnya dia akan keluar, dia akan ada extrusion from the diamond panels. Okay, the way to do it is just it's a simple concept. Kita kena move the panels ke depan in a axis, and then from the original surface to the next surface yang dah dimove tu akan di-connected, and then dia akan create the extrusion. Sama macam push and pull. Cuma in this case, dia akan ada slider yang akan boleh control dia punya extrusion. Okay, then you guys what you guys have to do is double click on the canvas and then tekan move. Dia akan keluar this tools, move. And then you guys boleh ambil from diamonds ni, connect pada G. Then dia akan move to an axis. Tapi kita tak specify lagi apa axis. In this case, kita nak go to X axis. So double click on the canvas, tekan X. Ada unit X. Unit X ni connect to the T. T ni is the motion, dia punya basically the vector. Vector of the movement. Okay, and then give a value to the X. In this case, kita letak, let's say 5. Double click and then tekan 5, enter. Okay, now dia dah move 5 units from the original surface eh. Okay, now kita akan connectkan these two original and the one that dah move into extrusion. What you want to do is double click on the canvas and then tekan weave. Dah dapat ke? Nice box tadi?
Tak, okay. The second file installs properly. So lepas tu you just close down, and bila you restart balik and you restart balik Grasshopper, it should be working well. Yeah.
Oh, sekarang tengah restart lah ni?
I dah restart tapi I baru realize I tak save tadi. I'm just gonna watch you.
Tak apa, nanti at the end of the class nanti I'll give this file to you guys juga, so that okay, you guys boleh nampak all the full things.
Alright, thanks.
Tapi yang lain dapat dapat tak lunchbox? Dah boleh eh? Okay.
Okay, dah boleh.
Okay. Okay. Sekarang ni kita dah ada weave. Weave ni is just another tools untuk kita connectkan those two things. Okay. Bear in mind yang sekarang ni kita kena aware yang ada dua types of surface yang kita dah ada, which is the original diamonds ni and then yang dah move. Okay, weave ni the function dia is to be like this. Okay. Tapi what I want you guys to do first is dekat weave ni, dekat zero, right click and then tekan graph. And then dekat one pun do the same thing, tekan right click and then graph. These things yang you guys see ni dekat sini, all these menus ni is a bit complicated sikit. So I won't be explaining benda ni sekarang, tapi just for the sake of this exercise, just do this, tekan graph and then connectkan diamonds yang from the original tadi to the zero, and then yang dah move ambil G geometry to number one. Okay, and then boleh offkan preview from the diamonds and offkan preview from the movement. Okay, sekarang dia akan, kita dah weave benda ni. And then kita nak connectkan between those two sebab dia still kosong kan tengah ni. What we're going to do is kita akan guna loft. Double click, tekan L-O-F-T, loft. Okay, and then connectkan yang weave result ni to the C. Okay, now dia akan dapat macam ni. Dapat? Dapat eh? Okay. Kalau nak, let's say lah saja nak gedik, nak nampak lawa sikit, this is a different case sikit. Sebab let's say lah nak nampak merah ni tak best kan? What you guys can do is double click, tekan custom preview. Tekan custom preview, This is just for the materials. And then connectkan L ni to the G. And then M ni is for the materials. You can choose the color. Double click, tekan swatch. Color swatch. And then connect kepada M. And then boleh tekan dekat color putih ni. And then tukarlah color korang apa yang korang nak. Swatch. Jumpa tak color swatch?
Yep.
Okay. Apa eh? So jadilah satu diagram. Dah siap.
Okay.
Okay. But now, kalau you guys nampak, this is not parametrically, dia tak cukup parametric lagi sebab dia punya extrusion ni semua based on one value yang sama, which is tadi 5 kan. What I'm going to show you guys is macam mana kita nak, the concept of macam mana kita nak parametrikan benda ni. And,
sebelum tu, just to show everyone, cuba you adjust slider yang awal-awal on the,
boleh.
And then just to show how different it is, how easy it is to change.
Okay.
It.
Let's say lah, I do the radius. Let's say I change the radius. Okay, boleh nampak? This is the radius of the polygon yang awal-awal tadi kita letak. Let's say segment. Segment could be different sikit sebab dia akan sama je. Cuma sebenarnya sekarang ni dia tengah pentagon. Dia tengah hexagon. Nampak? Kalau kita change balik kepada ni, sekarang dia tukar jadi pentagon. And then kalau balik keempat, dia akan jadi pada square balik. So this is the beauty of it lah. You get to tweak everything from the, basically macam tweak the DNA of the design tau. It's not about terus construct your bone, terus ada the flesh and everything, is the DNA. Maksudnya you tweak one simple DNA and then they change everything. So that's the whole concept of it lah. Let's say lah, from diamonds, kita boleh tweak dekat diamond ni kan, U division. Just tambahkan dia punya division, then dia tambah.
Yeah.
Okay, faham eh? Okay, then back to 20. Okay, now kita akan try variskan dia punya exclusion value. But dia akan being affected by a factor yang can be anything else. Maksudnya can be dia akan so varies tau dia punya factor yang boleh change the parametric behavior in environmental setting sebab this is dia kena connect sikit pada environmental. Let's say lah you want to do a facade yang boleh react to the sun punya height, sun punya movement through east and west. Maksudnya dia ada time yang sun tu akan dekat rendah, maksudnya dia tengah di sunrise, maksudnya kedudukan dia lebih rendah. But at the same time, bila dah tengah hari, dia kedudukan dia akan lebih tinggi. So macam mana you guys nak use that information to change your design untuk affect your design or to affect your parametric design. So in this case, kita akan I will show you the concept of it's a representation of sun. It could be in sun, a representation of a sun as a point, and kita akan kira the distance between the sun as a point to each panels. And then based on the distance, dia akan ada the shorter the distance, dia akan create a longer extrusion. Boleh faham tak? Boleh faham?
Maksudnya
okay.
Kalau dia banyak kena cahaya matahari, so the thickness will be longer.
Maksudnya okay macam ni. Let's say lah, okay. Despite memang susah sikit nak explain, dia kena
tengok.
Okay. Kena tengok sikit. Okay, imagine this block ni is a sun. Okay, and sun ni kita boleh move dia. Let's say lah, the sun to change from day to night kan.
Slow sikit.
Oh, sorry. Okay, kalau you guys can see, when I change the sun, the panel tu pun akan berubah. The closer the panels to the sun, in this case, extrusion dia akan lagi banyak. Nampak?
Okay.
Faham?
Okay, faham.
Faham eh? Okay. So, this is apa yang kita akan achieve sekarang. This part dia akan lebih complicated, so korang kena fokus sikit eh. Okay. Okay, first thing yang you guys have to do is establish sun ni. Dekat mana korang nak letak sun ni? And it can be anywhere lah basically. Tapi in this case, just letakkan korang punya view ni almost macam ni, more or less macam ni, so that X tu bahagian depan. And then double click on the canvas and then click point. Find satu point, dia akan keluar this one. And then right click on the point and then tekan set one point and then move pada Rhino punya windows and click dekat Rhino. They can establish satu point dekat Rhino.
Okay.
Okay. And then kalau you guys click dekat point yang dekat Rhino tu, just click. Oh sorry, click dekat grasshopper. Highlightkan points tu dekat grasshopper, dia akan keluar gumball, it's called gumball. Benda dia akan keluar this anak panah. Keluar tak?
Okay, yeah.
Keluar. Just move kan je. Tekan yang blue arrow ni, tekan ni atas. This is the representation of sun lah buat masa ni.
Dalam Rhino ni, how do you move specifically? Maknanya macam kalau dah AutoCAD kita boleh bagi
design. That is a very very saddening thing lah about Rhino. Dia snap dia is very susah. Dia susah sikit nak snap. For the sake of this exercise, just locate it somewhere. Yang part snap tu memang susah. I'll tell you.
Okay.
Just
we'll
move.
We'll figure that one out later. Yeah.
Okay, so kalau you guys nak nampak macam sphere ni tadi, so that boleh faham kan, just double click and then tekan sphere, S-P-H-E-R-E, tekan sphere, connectkan the dots, the points to B and then setkan dia punya radius to macam tadi 10 and then connect pada R. Okay. Sekarang ni kita dah ada the sun basically. Sekarang ni apa yang kita, next one yang kita akan buat is kita akan kira, kita akan justify a points dekat panels, dekat diamond panels ni. Dekat mana points yang to control everything, the position of the panels. So to do it, you guys double click on the canvas and type polygon center. And dia akan keluar this one. Polygon center. Okay, dapat?
Yeah.
Polygon center. And then connectkan diamonds yang tadi tu, yang awal tadi, diamonds to P. Dia akan establish all the central point of, all the center point of the diamond patterns. So dia akan keluar macam ni. Dapat eh? Okay, and then double click again on the canvas and then tekan point sahaja. Dia akan keluar this point tools and then ambil yang CE, which is the average dekat tengah-tengah, dan connectkan pada point. Okay, now kita dah ada point dekat panels and another one kita dah ada points dekat facade. Dekat sun. Sun ni is the another point. Okay, sekarang ni apa yang kita akan buat, kita akan kira the distance from each point from here to this point, to the sun. That is the variables yang kita ada sekarang, yang kita dah justify sekarang. To do it, you guys tekan, double click on the canvas, tekan distance. This is a tool yang akan kira the distance between two points. And then connect the points from the panels, tekan connect pada A, and then the sun tadi connect pada B, pada B. Okay, now kalau you guys hover dekat D, dia akan tunjuk the exactly the distance between those two points. Okay, so sekarang ni this is the distance yang kita nak guna. Tapi distance dia akan vary, so dia jauh lah kalau let's say from, let's say lah in a real life kan, maksudnya from building to the sun, mesti lah like beribu-ribu, berjuta-juta, I don't know, dia punya distance. But apa yang kita boleh buat sekarang is kita boleh, it's called remap, R-E-M-A-P, remap those values into a values, into a range of values yang kita nak. Faham tak? Maksudnya, let's say lah, for one thousand kilometer punya distance, kita nak the facade to extrude 0.1 meter. This is what yang kita akan buat lepas ni. Sebab kita takkan nak facade tu extrude sampai 1,000 kilometer kan? Kita nak dia just extrude like few 0 point something meters. So this is apa yang kita akan buat, which is called remap. So to do the remap, you guys kena ambil right click, double click on the canvas and then tekan and then type remap numbers. Okay, remap numbers. And then just for the punya pair, and then next one is you guys kena type bounds. Ambil bounds. And then next one is domain. Oh sorry. Next one is construct domain. Construct domain. Okay, tiga benda ni is very important sebab basically everything akan guna this tiga benda ni. Sebab from the distance ataupun from the apa-apa variables yang you guys nak letak, everything kalau perlu di remap, tiga benda ni akan jadi, tiga benda ni akan digunakan. So the way tiga benda ni jadi is, tiga benda ni digunakan is, the first one is, this is the distance of the original distance yang you guys dah ada. Maksudnya the distance from the one point to another. So this is the list of the distance. So you guys tekan connect from D to V. V ni is the value to remap, maksudnya list tadi tu. Value to remap. And then bounds ni tadi, the function dia untuk tahu the minimum values and the maximum values. So apa you guys have to do, ambil D, tekan pada connect pada N, number tadi, and then the result dia I go to S. S ni dia punya source of domains. So that dia tahu mana minimum and maximum. Okay, sekarang ni dia dah ada value of minimum and maximum dekat remap. Tapi what is the value yang kita nak impose on these things? Let's say lah from a facade ni tadi, the shortest facade, the shortest extrusion yang you guys nak is 0.1. So double click on the canvas, tekan 0.1. And then connect daripada A. And let's say the longest kali is 2 meters. Kita nak pergi nampak beza kan? 2.0. Click 2.0, enter, and then tekan and connect to B. Okay, once dah siap, from this domain, I ni connect pada T. Okay, now I want you guys to untuk double click on the canvas and type panel. Panel ni dia allow kita untuk nampak the data dalam setiap tools. And then cuba you guys try connectkan R to the panel. Okay, now dia akan keluar value yang range from 0.1 to 2.0. Tapi dia ada same quantity of points. Dia ada same quantity, dia ada same quantity from the points. Maksudnya tadi let's say kita ada, kalau tengok tadi, result ni kita ada 86 points. Tengok dia ada 86 locally defined values. Maksudnya dia ada, kat sini ada 86 point. And they create 86 points ni to the distance of the sun. And dekat sini pun, result dia is kita ada 86 remap numbers Tapi value dia is the value of exclusion yang kita nak. Okay, dapat? This is just for the visual understanding lah. Okay, okay.
Okay.
Okay, now kita dah dapat this value. Apa yang kita boleh buat dengan value ni is, kalau you guys pergi balik belakang tadi dekat diamonds and the move part, the move tools ni, kita ada value yang kita establish permanently kan tadi, ada 5. This is the 5 tadi, yang kita ada 5 meter tak tadi? Jumpa tak? Apa yang you guys have to do, tekan R, connect R ni, connect pada X tadi. Okay, and then pergi kat custom preview and then preview balik. Okay, nampak tak beza dia? Berjaya?
Okay.
Okay, tapi in this case, dia punya konsep dia terbalik tau. Kalau nampak, ke atas in a building punya sense, dekat atas pula yang nipis, tapi kat bawah pula yang tebal kan. Maksudnya value tadi tu, dia terbalik. Cara dia kira value tu terbalik sikit. Dia tersalah, bukan dia tersalah, it's just dia punya method tu boleh di change lah. What you guys have to do is right click on the R kat map numbers tu, right click, tekan reverse. Then dia akan reverse dia punya, akan reverse dia punya setting, reverse dia punya extrusion tadi. Dapat?
Okay.
Now from dari sini, cuba korang play with the slider. Let's say lah dekat dia punya highest value possible tadi, yang dekat 2 meters tadi, dekat 2 point unit tu, dekat 2 units, just slidekan lagi panjang. Dapat? And then yang minimum tadi pun kita boleh tukar. Let's say lah minimum dia kita tak nak terlampau nipis kan. Let's say lah you want to 0.5 and change dekat A. See, yang paling bawah tadi tak adalah sampai 0.1 je keluar, dia keluar 0.5. Okay, faham? Okay, this apa yang kita baru buat tadi ni, this remap thing and the distance ni is the most versatile application now yang you can do in Rhino and Grasshopper. Maksudnya it can be anything. It's not just about extrusion. The same thing can be used untuk scale. Maksudnya tadi kita tengok the parameter is a different extrusion. Maksudnya yang bawah extrusion dia pendek, yang atas panjang. Tapi imagine what if the scale of the panel tu dia boleh besar and kecil. Tapi dia remap to the same distance and they produce the same factor of scale. So maksudnya yang belah bawah ni nanti dia akan scale kecil, tapi belah atas scale besar. Boleh faham?
Amin. I think kita wrap dulu on
boleh?
This part.
Because boleh?
I think they need time to digest benda ni and then to decide what you need to do.
Because okay.
At the moment, what you're showing is quite on the advanced state lah.
Oh yeah.
So okay, sekarang okay. Ni basically what we need to do is to bridge between what they already know. So most of them tahu pasal SketchUp, most of the students already know SketchUp, and then they have been exposed to Revit.
Yep.
Yeah. Jadi sekarang nak tahu how does this work in terms of dia orang punya modeling, because kalau dia orang tak tahu, kalau the students tak tahu macam nak apply benda ni later,
then
dia akan nampak what's the point kan.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I understand that some of the students sekarang ni are quite concerned when it comes to okay, how do I bring this into the model.
Yep.
So just to recap this back for the students, you can see now that you boleh design satu fasad yang sekarang ni reaktif kepada matahari. Reaktif tu is a relative word, because sekarang ni I tak expect you buat fasad yang sentiasa bergerak ikut matahari macam kinetik fasad atau transformable fasad. macam bunga matahari, they just follow matahari, whatever it is. So I don't expect you to do that. Kalau you okay, why not? By all means. Tapi what I do expect is that, katalah you dah dapat this formula, okay, let's say lepas you try, okay, Jaza, this is the best apa outcome yang mana semua ruang dekat dalam bangunan ni akan dapat exposure yang optimal for daylighting. Okay, you export. Right? I don't expect you to actually model dia sampai habis kat sini. But biasanya apa yang Amin dan kawan-kawan dia buat ialah selepas dia dapat this fasad, bring it into SketchUp atau what else you guys use? Revit dan sebagainya, kan?
In my case, I use Revit.
Okay. And then Revit. Atau paling teruk pun AutoCAD lah. AutoCAD 2D kan. You export dia kepada AutoCAD 2D, so you don't have to recalculate everything manually. But the point is, kita nak bawa, yang paling penting sekali, kita nak bawa ke apa you buat untuk simulate daylighting tu?
Apa, radiation value ke Velux?
Velux. So, you are export ke Velux. Biasanya you buat dalam ni terus ke ataupun you export ke SketchUp or something?
SketchUp. Sebab dekat sini susah sikit.
So, basically what they usually do ialah export ni ke SketchUp and then you simulate daylighting dalam Velux. So there are lots of transfer of apa use of technology yang you akan bawa from one software to another. But this is the one of the strong point of our group. So kita akan gunakan benda ni because nobody else does it. Kalau dekat luar sana tu, this is a very specialist punya skill. Kalau you tak tahu, tak dapat master sekarang pun tak apa, because the point here is you are exposed to it. So kalau you dekat practice nanti, boss you akan hantar you untuk proper training and you already know at least the beginner's part of it, right? So for today, kita akan wrap dekat sini dulu. So hopefully ada kejap lagi I akan pass the recording to all of you, so you boleh refer step by step from the beginning. Yang kita nak apa yang kita belajar sekarang pada hari ini ialah you punya model does not have to be built manually. Maksudnya, dalam SketchUp tu, I would say that thing is built manually. Dekat sini, we show you an advanced example of how your entire model can be built by math. Okay? Dan dia taklah sesusah macam yang you sangka. So sekarang ni, every component yang ada dekat dalam ni, controllers, variables dan sebagainya, can be inserted dekat dalam satu controller and then being passed. Biasanya dia inserted on the left side and right side. Betul kan? Kan?
Betul.
The controller ni.
Yeah.
So maknanya kalau setiap satu controller yang you letak kat sini, what is it called? Component eh?
Boleh lah. Components.
Okay. Setiap satu component ni, for example, untuk buat extrusion atau untuk buat weave dan sebagainya. These are all benda-benda yang you boleh masukkan dan you control. Dia ada input dan ada output. And input usually comes in the form of numbers. Okay. You boleh masukkan integer. Macam I want this to be 3 meters high. I want this to be 4 meters high. Sama macam dalam SketchUp. Tapi at the same time, dia juga boleh carikan information. For example, jarak dinding ni dengan jarak dinding A, jarak dinding A dengan jarak dinding B, cari titik tengah dia, automatically input ke dalam salah satu controller yang lain, yang mana dia akan do different mathematical calculation, whatever you want them to do, and use that number for something else. For example, sekiranya distance antara dinding A dengan dinding B ialah 3 meter, maka lantai B is marble. So you have a system yang mana yang kata jarak antara dua dinding akan menentukan what kind of floor type you have. So, of course, floor type tu you yang set dulu. Kalau dia 2 meters, it's marble. Kalau dia 3 meters, it's granite. If it's 4 meters, it's cimeranda and whatever. So, grasshopper is a good way to automate that one. Okay? You tak payah decide. You tak payah kira satu persatu and measure. Dia akan automatically measure it for you. Okay? So, this is about recursive design lah. So, bila you buat satu parameter or multiple parameters yang combine together, they can help you do everything quite easily. Okay? So, anything you want to add, Amin?
I think for the very first step ni is you guys have to understand, you have to find out apa control yang you want to have. Maksudnya you have to macam search dekat YouTube, search dekat Google and everything, apa lagi behavior of parametric design yang available. Maksudnya in my case I already do rotation, extrusion and scaling. So that is three parametric behavior yang you guys boleh guna. Tapi at the same time there are a lot more lagi yang you can discover. It's not, this is actually is very, what I did ni is actually very basic lah. Maksudnya in Grasshopper punya form is very basic. It's just about extrusion. Ada orang yang buat lagi dia punya behavior lagi pelik and everything based on curves lah. Dia akan project more curve wall, at the same time dia relate to this. So explore, if you guys really want to pursue benda ni, doing Grasshopper and Rhino, go search apa yang available and then tweak kat mana yang you guys need and everything, and that's it. In fact yang all these things you can even download online pun. Maksudnya ramai je orang yang share all these things dekat online so that orang lain boleh guna. Sebab this is not a design technically, it's a code yang you can apply any kind of design. Maksudnya doesn't mean kalau you guys download it from someone else, the design tu can be totally same. Sebab you guys can boleh tweak everything. Sebab benda tu semua boleh tweak. So don't be so discouraged lah. Yeah, because I did too. But then I found out macam, oh rupanya boleh je download and then tweak. So tak payah construct daripada awal pun sebenarnya. Macam in this case, I will be sharing this with you guys so that you guys boleh understand and you guys tweak lah as much as possible. So you nak tukar pattern lain, nak tukar surface lain, nak tukar behavior lain, then tukar. As long as the essence is, apa-apa pun essence dia akan still sama. Don't worry.
Okay guys, kalau tak ada apa-apa, I'm going to say on the behalf of the students and the Recursive Design Group, thank you very much, Amin.
Okay, welcome. No problem.
Okay. Alright. Okay, thank you, Amin. Thank you very much.
Okay, welcome.
Okay, thank you guys.
Okay. Thank you.